apparently fit. The 1500 metres final at the Bell, Ovett succumbed.
Well, Ben goes really hard for 60 and then he was going to die the last 40. And once the race started, we realized that he didn't go so hard for 60, but he still carried on. I mean, if you look at the old Westerns in the U.S., they had the guy in the white hat and then the guy in the black hat. You know, I felt that being the clean guy that was going out trying to win, I was the guy in the white hat, and I was trying to beat this evil guy.
The Westland goal first time, and Ben Johnson got a brilliant start. It's Johnson away and clear, and Lewis is not going to catch him. Johnson wins it. Lewis second, Christie third, and the world record has gone again.
When I crossed the finish line second, there were a couple of things that went through my mind. First of all, obviously I was not very happy because I still felt I was better than he was. But when I went over to congratulate him, the first thing he did was he kind of turned away from me. You know, he kind of wouldn't shake my hand back. And I had to physically grab his hand and put it in my hand and say, "You're going to shake me. I'm not going to walk across here. You don't deserve it. But I'm not going to congratulate you in front of the world and not allow you to do it. You know, you're not going to shun me now. I came over here when I shouldn't have."
I've just been handed a piece of paper here that, if it's right, it'll be the most dramatic story out of these Olympics or perhaps any others.
The urine sample of Ben Johnson, Canada, athletics 100 meter, collected on Saturday 24 September 1988, was found to contain the metabolites of a banned substance, namely stanozolol. It's an anabolic steroid.
Removing Ben from the Canadian team. Ben is now en route.
Well, I think it's sad that this thing happened.
The only solution to the doping problem.
Well, I'm very pleased because I feel that all the athletes should be clean.
You've been described as the greatest cheat in world sport. What do you say to that?
Because they're jealous, because they can't run that fast. And even today, they're taking lots of drugs, trying to run 979, and they can't run that fast. So how they get there, they have no idea.
What about the cheat bit, though? Does it hurt?
It doesn't hurt me.
Was I shocked? Yes, I was indeed. Because, you know, you hear the rumors and everything else, and athletes, notice for that. They go out and then they spread gossip about everybody. You know, you could be there and, you know, as soon as you do it's a good time, everyone says, "Oh, he's on drugs," until they go out there and run the same time, then they realize, "Oh God, you know, I'm not on drugs, so maybe it's legal, maybe it can be, you know, it can be done." So, you know, you always hope that, you know, everyone gets caught, but you never think it of people.
We knew that people on drugs, they can turn it on and turn it off. Human beings cannot turn things on and off. But machines can, and that's what someone on drugs is a machine. So he would look coy in the heat, and then he'd come back, boom, explode in the final.
I was so psyched that I didn't know what was going on. All I hear was just the noise, was just people just screaming and stuff like that.
And you knew he cheated this?
Oh, absolutely. We knew for years. It was in the track world, it was very obvious. It wasn't even a question.
The IOC Medical Commission recommends the following sanction: disqualification of this competitor from the games of the 24th Olympiad in Seoul.
Let's get this straight. You weren't taking any sort of drugs at all to improve your performance. Is that what you're actually saying to
us? I was clean.
Why did the test show that you weren't clean then?
I don't know. Thanks be there. I'm the doctor.
It's interesting to see you smile and laugh. It must be extremely annoying then if you're saying you're an innocent man and people look at you and say, no, he's not. He took drugs. He must be furious.
Well, I can't go around hating people for what people said. I mean, my job is to run, and that was my job.
Whenever you catch someone, no matter what level it is, it shouldn't be a negative for the sport. It should be a positive. You should say, instead of saying, oops, another guy's caught, everyone's on it, you should say, hey, we're not tolerating anyone on it.
You do admit, though, to taking some sort of drug at Seoul. Is that correct?
Well, at the Dublin inquiry, I admit that I was taking drugs for a certain period of time, but not that drug, what they find in my body. I was taking up until, you know, the Seoul Games.
You were taking steroids,
yes.
Is that correct?
Yes.
The gold medalist, Ben Johnson, Canada.
My job was go there to run. I can't say our feeling that I won't get caught. I mean, whenever time comes, it comes. But so far, I'm going to enjoy myself and run fast and prove to the world that I'm the best runner ever run.
If you could have your time over again, would you do anything different at all?
That's a good question. I can answer that so many different ways, but I won't answer that. No, I won't answer that one.
Well, why not? Because obviously that's jarred with you, that question, so why won't you answer it?
No, I won't answer that one. I leave that one alone.